Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome everyone to the Great American Hall here at the Hershey Lodge for the New Birth of Freedom Council's 8th Annual Eagle Scout Recognition Dinner. My name is Evan Forrester, a Fox 43 WPMT, Executive Board Member of the New Birth of Freedom Council, and fellow Eagle Scout. It is my honor, certainly this evening, to serve as your Master of Ceremonies. Our program will now begin with the introduction of our 2017 class of Eagle Scouts. I call on our Eagle Scout Recognition Dinner honoree, David Kleppinger, and Dinner Chairman Greg Smith to come forward to greet and congratulate our 2017 class of Eagle Scouts. After each Eagle Scout introduces himself, he will be presented with a special Eagle Scout coin to mark this occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my sincere pleasure to present to you the New Birth of Freedom Council's 2017 class of Eagle Scouts.
From Troop 256, and I'm from Harrisburg, PA.
My name's Adam Minarch. I'm from Troop 80, and we're from Mechanicsburg, PA.
My name is Jordan Cooper. I'm from Troop 107 in New Oxford.
My name is Timothy Zieber from Troop 108 in Hershey, PA.
My name is Aaron Frim. I'm from Troop 205 from Shrewsbury, Pennsylvania.
My name is Michael Gilliland. I'm from Troop 54 and I'm also from York, PA.
My name is George Mason Demers. I'm from York, Pennsylvania, Troop 25.
My name is Devin Evanitis. I'm from Troop 25 in York, Pennsylvania.
My name is Alex Joka. I'm from Troop 97, US Fitzhown, PA.
My name is Seth Cody. I'm from Chambersburg and from Troop 514.
My name is Joseph Novacek. I'm from Troop 198, Edders, PA.
Matthew Snyder, Troop 151, Millersburg, PA.
My name is Josh Fox. I'm from Troop 256, and I'm from Harrisburg, PA.
Hi, I'm Tim Selwood. I'm from Troop 180, and I was born in South Africa, but my troop is Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Matthew Powell, Troop 5, Carlisle, PA.
I'm Bax Rearbaum from Troop 51. I live in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Tom Gamble. I'm from Troop 168 in Carlisle, Pennsylvania.
My name is Joseph Domino. I'm from Troop 168 in Carlisle, Pennsylvania.
My name is Carson Schultz. I'm from Troop 296 in Camp Hill, PA.
My name is Drew Heidelbaugh. I'm from Mechanicsburg, PA, and Troop 276.
I'm Austin Rex Road from Troop 27, Stuartstown, PA.
My name is Daniel Shank. I'm from Troop 196 in Hampton Township, PA.
My name is Connor Laughlin. I'm from Troop 120 in Shippensburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Nathan Klancic. I'm in Troop 110 in Hanover, Pennsylvania.
My name is Jared Stebick. I'm from Troop 110 in Hanover, PA.
My name is Jared Knobb, and I'm from Troop 66, and I'm from Middletown, Pennsylvania.
My name is Liam Bishop. I'm from Troop 54 in Camp Hill, PA.
My name is Karen Shade. I'm from Troop 26. My hometown is Wrightsville, PA.
My name is Peter Zellis. I'm from 225 in York, PA.
My name is Michael Hare. I am from Troop 360 in Harrisburg, PA.
My name is Andrew Lavelle. I'm from Troop 594 out of Middletown, Pennsylvania.
My name is Matthew Lavelle from 594 out of Middletown, Pennsylvania.
My name is Ryan Dotson. I'm from Troop 50 in York, PA.
My name is Grant Helmsetter. I'm from Troop 125, New Oxford, PA.
My name is Logan Davis. I'm from Troop 192, New Cumberland, Pennsylvania.
My name is Dawson Garrett. I'm from York, PA, Troop 54.
My name is Derek Harlacker from Troop 94 in York, PA.
My name is Brent Forey from Troop 150 in York, Pennsylvania.
My name is Micah Reif from Troop 125, Chambersburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Christian Lowe, Troop 121, Shippensburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Nate Stauffer. I'm from Troop 77 in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Patrick Dorsey from Troop 196 in Camp Hill, PA.
My
My name is Louis Seven. I'm from Troop 27 in Storrstown, Pennsylvania.
I'm Brendan Little from Troop 66 in Hummelstown, Pennsylvania.
My name is Tanner Martin. I'm from Troop 203 from Dillsburg, Pennsylvania.
My name is Ben Laverdier, and I'm from Troop 262, Grantville, Pennsylvania.
My name is Anthony Metzger. I'm from Troop 94 in York, Pennsylvania.
My name is Joram Culbertson from Troop 120 in Shippensburg, PA.
My name is Matthew Sheehy from Troop 65 in Hershey, PA.
My name is Nolan Beislein. I'm from Troop 1165 and I'm from Halifax, PA.
My name is Matthew Campbell. I'm from Troop 200, Hummelstown, PA.
My name is Josh Titus, Troop 1165, Halifax.
My name is Nick Reiner from Halifax, Troop 1165.
I'm Colin Millis. I'm from Troop 277, York, PA.
My name is Alexander Bongart, Troop 90, Shrewsbury, PA.
My name is Ian Ward. I'm from Newville, Pennsylvania, and in Troop 185.
My name is Preston Howe. I'm from Troop 186 in Shippensburg.
My name is Dominic DiLorenzo from Troop 186 in Carlisle, Pennsylvania.
I'm Lee Deal from Troop 186, Carlisle.
My name is Lucas Shank. I'm from Troop 186, Carlisle, Pennsylvania.
My name is Dakota Miller, Troop 92, and I'm Bloomfield, PA.
My name is Matt Redding. I'm part of Troop 78, and I'm from Cashtown, PA.
Hi, my name is Carl Zerby, and I'm from Troop 66 of Hummelstown, PA.
I'm Paul Weiser from Troop 155 in Red Lion, Pennsylvania.
I'm Samuel Johnson from Troop 50, East Berlin, PA.
My name is Duncan Gerard. I'm from Troop 146 in Wiconisco, Pennsylvania.
I'm Benjamin Monaco from Troop 77 out of Harrisburg, PA.
I'm Brady Rivera from Troop 105 in Hanover, PA.
My name's Grant Goldberg, Troop 105, Hanover, PA.
I'm Luke Motter from York, Pennsylvania, Troop 25.
I'm Christopher Lorenzen from Troop 155 in Red Lion, Pennsylvania.
I'm Ethan Davia from Troop 24 in New Freedom, Pennsylvania.
I'm Alexander Laverdier from Troop 262 in Grantville, PA.
I'm Max Dadswell from Troop 65 in Hershey.
I'm Nathaniel Kopp. I'm from Troop 75 in Bendersville, PA.
I'm Timothy Henry. I'm from Troop 67 and I'm from Dover, PA.
I'm Drew Mancuso from Troop 185 from Walnut Bottom.
Pierce Heimbach, Troop 68, Lingolstown, Pennsylvania.
I'm George Cornwell from Troop 170, Mount Holly, PA.
I'm Herman McCoskey from Troop 170 in Carlisle. I'm from Carlisle, Pennsylvania. And I'd also like to introduce Malachi Kolchek. He's also from Troop 170 from Mount Holly Springs, PA, and he is currently at basic training for the Marine Corps.
I'm Zach Ryan from Troop 198 from Eddowes, PA.
Jacob Madigan from Troop 23 in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Lodgewin Hornbaker from Troop 514 from Chambersburg, PA.
I'm Matthew Lawrence, Troop 296 from Mechanicsburg, PA.
Cameron Kefford from Troop 88, Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Wade Shank from Troop 120 in Shippensburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Benjamin Spangler from Troop 203, Hershey, Pennsylvania.
I'm Ethan Stoner from Troop 190 in Grantham, Pennsylvania.
I'm Jeremiah Joel from Troop 308 in Lingolstown, Pennsylvania.
I'm Wesley Strohecker from Troop 304 in, what, that's not right, Troop 180 in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania. Sorry.
I'm Sam Colosimo from Troop 180 in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Mike Gordon from Troop 276 in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
Pierce Weigler, Troop 75, Hershey, Pennsylvania.
I'm Drew Clancy from Troop 168 from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Cameron Clark from Troop 54 in Camp Hill, Pennsylvania.
I'm Bradford Schuchart, Troop 76, Fairfield, Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
Nathan Yankelov, Troop 27, Stuartstown, Pennsylvania.
AJ Magnani out of Troop 27 from Stuartstown, Pennsylvania.
Brady Paul Hemus out of Troop 35 out of Red Lion, Pennsylvania.
I'm Jonathan Malone from Troop 74 of Palmyra, Pennsylvania.
I'm Kennedy Akpane from Troop 69 in York, Pennsylvania.
I'm Jared Hostler from Troop 69 in New York, Pennsylvania.
Ethan Nace, Troop 69, Loganville, Pennsylvania.
Matthew Cananizzato, Troop 296, Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania.
I'm Russell Stevens out of Troop 121, Shippensburg, Pennsylvania.
Chase Brevig from Troop 283 out of Mechanicsburg.
Dylan Abdel-Malak, Troop 97, New Salem, Pennsylvania.
Thomas Stratton, Troop 76, out of Fairfield, Pennsylvania.
Elam Cal, Troop 105, Blaine, Pennsylvania.
I'm Greg Comp from Troop 94, Shermansdale, Pennsylvania.
I'm Kevin Comp, Troop 94, Shermansdale, Pennsylvania.
I'm John Comp from Troop 94, Shermansdale, Pennsylvania.
Thank you, Mr. Pluckinger and Mr. Smith, and thank you, Eagle Scouts, for introducing yourselves to us. Ladies and gentlemen, there are a total of 238 members of the 2017 class of Eagle Scouts, 116 of which are present tonight. However, several of these young men are away at college, serving in the military, or out of town and not able to be with us tonight. So let's applaud all their accomplishments as well. At this time, I call Gregory Comp, John Comp, and Kevin Comp from Troop 94, New Bloomfield, back to the stage to conduct our opening for this evening. You'll note that Gregory, John, and Kevin share the same last name, which is not only because they are brothers, but are triplets who have each earned their Eagle Award during this past year. They will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, will offer our invocation, and recite the Scout Oath and Law. At this time, I'd ask the audience to please stand.
May everyone that's able please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Scout salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Ready? Two.
Please prepare yourself best suitable for your faith for the prayer. Let us pray. O Lord, grant that I may possess the will and the strength to live up to my solemn obligations, to do my duty to God and my country, to serve my community, to all mankind, be trustworthy, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent, to help others at all times, especially those who are weak or in need, to assist my fellow scouts along the Eagle Trail, providing leadership and inspiration that they may also experience the fulfilling reward of scouting, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight in every undertaking of my daily life, to respect our wildlife and environment, to be prepared, and to do my best in every endeavor, never to forget that I am an Eagle Scout, and always to remember that I represent the ideals of the highest achievement in scouting, a symbol of good character and citizenship, and of wholesome worth and honor. Amen.
Would you please join me in the Scout Oath and Scout Law? Scout sign. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the Scout Law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Scout Law. A Scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Two.
Thank you, Gregory, John, and Kevin. Our Eagle Scouts may now find their tables. In the audience, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy dinner and the slideshow presentation of our newest Eagle Scouts and major sponsors. We'll resume the program right after dinner. Thank you.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Diana Kramer Zieber. Could you please meet us at stage left over here, please? Diana Kramer Zieber, please.
We certainly hope that everyone enjoyed their dinner. Let's say a huge thank you to the staff of the Hershey Lodge for preparing and serving a great meal for us this evening. Earning the Eagle Scout Award is the ultimate goal for youth in the Boy Scouting program. Requirements include earning at least 21 merit badges, demonstrating scout spirit, completing service hours, and holding leadership positions. This includes completing an extensive service project, which is scouting's most difficult advancement requirement. So it's fair to say that becoming an Eagle Scout is certainly no easy task. As we celebrate the accomplishments of these young men tonight, it is important to recognize that along their trail to the rank of Eagle Scout, they were given a lot of support and encouragement from two key groups of people that we would like to recognize at this time. First, we'd ask that all parents, family members, and friends of these Eagle Scouts with us here tonight, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Next, would all Scoutmasters with us tonight also stand and be recognized for your efforts? Thank you very much. By becoming an Eagle Scout, one joins a select group of men who will share this unique distinction the rest of their lives. Would all of my fellow Eagle Scouts in the audience, regardless of how long ago you may have received your award, please stand and be recognized. All Eagle Scouts. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce the president of the New Birth of Freedom Council, Dr. Kevin Mosier, to share his remarks on behalf of the council. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Kevin Mosier.
Greetings, everybody. First, I'd like to offer my congratulations and the congratulations of the executive board of the New Birth of Freedom Council to our Scouts who are in attendance this evening for achieving the rank of Eagle Scout. Earning the Eagle Scout Award is an incredible achievement, and you should be very, very proud. I'd also like to congratulate our honoree, David Kleppinger. And second, I would like to recognize the presenting sponsors of our dinner this evening. McNeese, Wallace, and Newark, and PSECU were both tremendously generous in their financial support of this event. So on behalf of the New Birth of Freedom Council, I offer my sincere thanks and gratitude to both of our presenting sponsors. I'd like to call David Kleppinger, Chairman of McNeese, Wallace, and Newark, and our honoree, and Greg Smith, President of PSECU, and our dinner chairman, to come forward to be recognized and receive a token of our appreciation. Please join me in a round of applause for our 2017 presenting sponsors. Okay, thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much for your sponsorship. So finally, this evening, I have a special request for all of our guests and scouting families to consider. As we all know, the U.S. territory of Puerto Rico was devastated by Hurricane Maria on September 20th of this year. The Category 4 hurricane drenched and battered the island with several feet of rain and 150 mile per hour winds, causing severe damage, flooding, and mudslides. Electricity is still not restored in many areas of the island and may not be for quite some time. Fresh drinking water has become very scarce. Members of the Boy Scouts of America living in Puerto Rico, which includes nearly 11,000 members across 300 scout units, have been severely impacted, as you can imagine. As this video will show, scouting facilities at the Puerto Rico Council were similarly affected. The council office, just south of the capital of San Juan, was damaged badly by the storm. The roof and air conditioning system need repairs. And inside the building, water damage is rampant. Fixing everything will take a very long time. The council has reopened its office, but it will be many months before they're back to normal. Their beautiful scout reservation also took a hit. Campsites were flooded with more than 3 feet of water. Trees were toppled, with some covering important roads. The camp has no power and must use generators on an island where diesel fuel is now a very expensive commodity. The camp's buildings were damaged by flooding, and most, if not all, of the equipment stored in the campsites, such as bunks, mattresses, etc., were damaged. Scouts help other people at all times, and our scouting brothers and sisters in the Puerto Rico Council need our help at this time. So in the spirit of Giving Tuesday, which is 1 week from today, we'd like each of you to consider making a donation tonight to help support the Puerto Rico Council, whose staff and volunteers are working hard to rebuild under circumstances we cannot imagine. All funds raised tonight in support of this request will go directly to the Emergency Assistance Fund that the BSA has established to help them. Placed inside your program book, you'll find a pledge card for the Puerto Rico Council Relief Appeal. It looks like this, with an envelope. A few pens were placed in the table as well, if you need one. So please take a moment to look at the pledge card and consider making a gift. If you can make a gift in any amount, please complete the card in the next few minutes. Be sure to sign your pledge card and be sure your information is complete. You can give your envelope to one of our council staff members who will be standing on either side of the exit doors. And I've come to learn that Jeff Spencer will always accept an envelope from you at any time. And as you depart, or you can give it to one of our staff members who will be standing on either side of the exit doors as you depart after the conclusion of the program. Or you can just leave your completed card on the table and we'll collect them after the event. Whatever you can do to help will make a difference. Again, congratulations to our Eagle Scouts and thank you.
Thank you, Kevin. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to introduce our featured Eagle Scout speaker tonight, Pierce Wagler from Troop 75 right here in Hershey. Pierce, you should know, has earned every single merit badge and every Catholic religious award and patch offered by the Boy Scouts of America. He served as the Boy Scout representative for the Diocese of Harrisburg and as a member of the Catholic Committee on Scouting. He is a Brotherhood member of the Order of the Arrow and past Vice Chief for the Keystone Capital Chapter. Pierce is also a recipient of the Junior Legion of Honor Award for the Chapel of the Four Chaplains. He plans to attend college to study psychology and business. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Eagle Scout Pierce Wagler.
Good evening. First, I would like to say thank you to the New Birth of Freedom Council for inviting me to speak tonight. And secondly, I'd like to say congratulations to the 2017 class of Eagle Scouts. It surely is an impressive feat. My name is Pierce Wagler. I am an Eagle Scout, and this is how it happened. I joined Boy Scouts in March of 2011 on my 11th birthday. I was very excited. My first summer camp was as painful as getting poked in the eye with a sharp stick, mainly because at my first summer camp, I accidentally was poked in the eye with a sharp stick and had to come home to have it treated. Now, you might call that an inauspicious start, but that didn't discourage me. My brothers and I joined Scouts around the same time. My older brother, Miles, was told by an adult Scout leader that at 15, he would not have enough time to reach Eagle Scout. Miles not only reached Eagle, but set his sights on earning 100 merit badges. He surpassed that mark, and as a result, also earned 2 Eagle Palms before he aged out. My brother Liam earned Eagle Scout and went on to earn every merit badge, at that time, 137. There are fewer than 350 scouts who have ever accomplished this task. Since my brothers and I did almost every event and merit badge together, I was roughly on the same pace for earning merit badges. I also earned every merit badge, at that time 137, and then the exploration merit badge was added after Liam had aged out. Earning exploration brought my total to 138, and that would be one more than you have, Liam. At Miles' Eagle ceremony, we were introduced to a scout from Milton Hershey School's Troop 75, who's trying very hard to earn Eagle Scout. He came as a guest with a friend of ours who was also a merit badge counselor. And since the scout was in uniform, Miles asked him to be part of his ceremony. Colton Doyle became our family's connection with Milton Hershey School's Troop 75. We became involved in their activities. My older brothers became adult scout leaders, and I was permitted to join the troop, although I was not a student at the school. Our activities over the past year and a half with the Milton Hershey School have been very rewarding on many levels. We have seen 5 scouts, including Colton Doyle and myself, earn Eagle Scout, and have witnessed the troop growing and becoming much more active under the leadership of Scoutmaster Rodney Sonderman and his wife, Amy. These 2 amazing people have been house parents at Milton Hershey School for 18 years. In that vocation, they not only guide, support, and encourage the young people under their care, but they also devote many hours to the scout troop and its recent success. Mr. Sonderman is also an assistant fire chief with the Hershey Volunteer Fire Department. He saves lives. I've seen it firsthand. There have been so many people who helped shape my experience through scouting. Adult leaders, merit badge counselors, and of course, the friends and brother scouts that I have met and worked with along the way. Scouting has led me to meet an abundance of great people, including 3 of my closest friends and the Sondermans, who I now consider family. I would be remiss if I didn't recognize my cousins, Ian and Patrick O'Keefe, and my brothers Miles and Liam, who have all earned Eagle Scout and served as such strong role models through my scouting career. I couldn't possibly mention everyone who deserves mention, but I would like to say thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Sonderman. Thank you, Jay Sherrato. Thank you, Colton Doyle, Ryan Sherrato, and Sawyer Smith. Thank you to my father, who's been there for me through as much as I can remember. And remember never to take for granted the people who you work with. They'll end up meaning so much more to you than you will ever expect. Scouting took an 11-year-old boy and turned him into a hardworking young man who stands up for what he believes and keeps his sights set in the right direction in spite of any sharp sticks. It's not the destination that matters, but the journey. The memories of the people you encounter on your journey will be the memories that you truly cherish for the rest of your life. Thank you.
Couple of things. Here's the front. Here, show them the back. There's the back. Back to the front. And over here's the overflow. All sewn on, or are they adhesive put on?
They're all sewn.
Well done. Like to present this to Pierce as a token of the council's appreciation. It is a signed print by the artist Joseph Satori, and it is called Eagle Scout Court of Honor. Well done, young man. With my son, I gave up and I used the adhesive. At this time, I'd like to call our dinner chairman, Greg Smith, to the podium for some important recognitions and also to introduce tonight's honoree. Ladies and gentlemen, Greg Smith.
Thank you, Evan. I'd first like to offer my congratulations to all the newest Eagle Scouts here with us tonight. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. And as Eagle Scouts, you're now better prepared to overcome any challenge that you may face in the years ahead. I wish each of you the best of luck. In addition to being an opportunity to recognize our honoree and our current class of Eagle Scouts this evening, this event also serves as an important source of funding to support the programs of the New Birth of Freedom Council, which is responsible for overseeing the effective delivery of scouting programs in 6 counties in South Central Pennsylvania. I'm pleased to announce that to date, tonight's dinner has raised over $118,500 for scouting. We appreciate all the contributions from those who have donated to this event and to scouting this year. Our success was made possible by having a fantastic committee whose hard work and dedication helped raise the funds in support of this event. I'd like to acknowledge our committee members tonight whose names appear on page 10 of your program and ask if they are present to please stand and be recognized for your outstanding efforts. Committee members are Sean Bale, Barbara Boker, Alan Boynton, Chip Brown, Keith Clark, Ron Drenovich, James George, Sean Gooden, Matthew Hare, Michael Kenny, David Kleppinger, Jeffrey Lobach, James Panabaker, Robert Scare, William Scott, David Skirpon, Morton Spector, and Julian Talbert. Let's give them a round of applause. I'd also like to say thank you to Jeff Shearer of Camera Box Professional Photography for taking our Eagle Class group photo and the Eagle Scout family photos. Final Focus Productions for providing video and technical support for tonight's program, and Josh Brown for putting together our Eagle Scout slideshow and closing video. Let's give them a round of applause also. I'd like to next recognize those who supported the dinner at the Eagle and Life sponsorship levels. We placed an engraved commemorative recognition plaque at their tables as a small way to say thank you for their significant gifts. Our Eagle sponsors include M&T Bank, Cleveland Brothers, McClure Company, and the Milton Hershey School. Our Life sponsors include Alexander Building Construction, Gary and Sylvie St. Hilaire, Capital Blue Cross, the Kinsley Foundation, Wellspan Health, and York Container. Let's give a big hand to all our sponsors this evening. It's now my sincere pleasure to introduce this year's honoree, David M. Kleppinger. David's the chairman of McNeese, Wallace, and Nurick. McNeese is the largest law firm located here in central Pennsylvania with over 132 attorneys in practice. PSECU has been a McNeese client for well over 20 years. As chairman of a law firm, David is essentially the CEO or chief executive of the company. Under his leadership, McNeese has been named as Pennsylvania Best Places to Work firm for the past 12 years consecutively. That's quite a distinction. Tonight's award is given to an individual who demonstrates a significant contribution to our local community. I believe that it ties into that part of the Scout Oath which calls on us to help other people at all times. Tonight's recipient has demonstrated his commitment to our community in so many ways. After graduating from Penn State University in 1977 with multiple honors, he was in the top 5% of his class with a 3.87% GPA. He was a Phi Beta Kappa inductee, as well as being a member of several other academic honors fraternities. Now, Dave, just, you know, we've got so many college people, or college age people here. Phi Beta Kappa is not the party fraternity, right? Yeah. While the other fraternities are partying, these guys are studying. It's a very, very select group of people that get inducted into that society. It's actually the nation's oldest honor society. So anyway, David attended law school at Temple University after graduating from Penn State, and he graduated from Temple in 1980. Again, David won numerous academic awards as he continued his education. David was hired by McNeese in 1980 and worked his way to the chairmanship of the firm in 2006. David's community involvement is significant. He serves on many boards and foundations here in central Pennsylvania. He serves on the Board of Trustees for Penn State University. He's the current first vice chair of the Pennsylvania Chamber of Business and Industry. He currently serves on the board of the Team Pennsylvania Foundation, and he's the current chair of the United Way of the Capital Region. David resides in Hummelstown with his wife, Joanne. They have two adult children, Brett and Lisa. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in recognizing my friend, David M. Kleppinger, as our 2017 Eagle Scout Recognition Dinner honoree.
Thank you, Greg, and thank you to the New Birth of Freedom Council for this prestigious award that, as they say in one of the comic movies, I feel I'm not worthy. When Chip Brown first came to see me and asked me about receiving this award, I said, "You understand I'm not an Eagle Scout." And he said that didn't matter, so I'm certainly humbled to be among such accomplished young men who have already achieved that Eagle Scout. As we were having dinner tonight and people were joking with me about my lack of home ownership skills, I thought, well, you know, if I would have been an Eagle Scout, maybe I could do that honey-do list a little bit better for my wife of 40 years who's here tonight. But unfortunately, I have to hire people to do that. Congratulations to each of you tonight that are receiving your Eagle Scout. It's a tremendous accomplishment. And also, congratulations to the parents of all of the Eagle Scouts who have obviously done a tremendous job in raising wonderful young men who are going to be future leaders of our country. A message I'd like to leave with the Eagle Scouts is think about what you've already achieved and how you have now already differentiated yourself from your peers and colleagues. As you move on through life, think about additional ways to differentiate yourself. Whether you choose to attend a trade school, whether you choose to go to the military, whether you choose to go to college, always think about how you can differentiate yourself and be a better person and serve our communities and our country in ways that not enough people do today. As a law firm and the chairman of the law firm, McNeese, Wallace & Norick, we always try to differentiate ourselves in a competitive legal industry. We do that by placing our clients first, by being the best places to work in Pennsylvania, as Greg already indicated, and by serving our community, which is the primary reason I believe I was selected for this honor. But it's not an individual honor. It's an honor that really goes to the entire law firm and the 275 people that are employed there. I just happen to be the chairman of a great organization that enables me to be in a position where I might be the public face of our service back to the community. But it's really 275 people at our law firm that do that. So I accept this award very humbly, not as an individual, but as a simple representative of a great law firm, McNeese, Wallace, and Norick. Thank you very much.
Thank you, David, and congratulations on this deserving honor this evening. A couple of remarks quickly. Those of you who did not get your family photos taken, I'm told you can still meet with a photographer in the room over here right after the program. And also, you can watch the program on the Council's YouTube channel starting tomorrow. For some final remarks, at this time I'd like to call on Ron Gardner, Scout Executive and Chief Executive Officer of the New Birth of Freedom Council and fellow Eagle Scout. Ron?
Good evening, everyone. To begin, there's several people I'd like to give special thanks to, starting with Evan Forrester, our Master of Ceremonies for this evening's event. I like to think of Evan as the official voice of the New Birth of Freedom Council, especially at occasions like tonight's dinner, and I'm very appreciative that he could break away from the station and his on-air responsibilities long enough to be here to anchor tonight's festivities. Evan, thank you very much. Next, I'd like to extend our thanks to Greg Smith, who served as this year's dinner chair. We are truly blessed to have a strong cadre of volunteers that were introduced earlier working together as our dinner committee, helping to make this event a success in all ways. That is, as is true with all championship teams, having a great coach and a great leader is important. And Greg set an excellent pace for our committee in putting together an outstanding fundraising effort to benefit the council, in addition to the recognition and memories we have created here tonight. Greg, if you could please come forward, I would like to present you with a token of our appreciation for your important role with this year's event. Our 2017 Eagle Scout class is, as always, a source of great pride and inspiration to us all. Reflecting the very best ideals and achievements in scouting, whether we look to Eagle Scouts like Pierce Wagler and his 138 merit badges, or Scouts like Alex and Ben Lavertier, whose extraordinary salesmanship skills have propelled them, listen to this, to personally sell more than $173,000 worth of popcorn and nuts during their scouting careers, and another $19,000 worth of camp cards. Could you two boys stand up, please? Where are you? I think you're over here. Wow. I could probably pull more names and more stories. Every Eagle Scout has a story worth telling. I want to recognize some other heroes in the room, to all the moms and dads. Like many of you, I have walked in your shoes. I have tried. I was successful in encouraging my two sons to finish their Eagle Scout trail. I have shared this story in the past at this event. My wife and I tried everything. We bribed, we encouraged, we threatened, we withheld car privileges, and you know, as the 18th birthdays approached, nothing was happening. And then almost miraculously, our sons both realized the value of what would be lost to them if they didn't finish what they had started. There was much to do and not much time to spare, but in the end, both of our sons made it to Eagle with just days to go before they turned 18. I would be willing to bet that many of the parents here tonight have similar stories to what I just said, where weeks of waiting turned to months and maybe even years of parental suffering, of wanting your sons to finish off their Eagle rank. On behalf of all of the procrastinating Eagle Scouts sitting here tonight, thanks to all the moms and dads for everything that you did to help your son achieve scouting's pinnacle. Give yourselves a hand. I began my professional career with the Boy Scouts back in 1983, and I will confess that I could never have imagined all of the changes that would take place within the Boy Scouts of America over the next 34 years. As you may have heard, starting in 2018, families can choose to sign up their sons and daughters for Cub Scouts. Chartered partner organizations, such as churches that sponsor our programs, may choose to establish a new Cub Scout pack just for girls, They could have a Cub Scout pack that serves both girls and boys in separate dens, or they could choose to remain an all-boy cub pack. Cub Scout dens will be single gender, either all boys or all girls. Also, starting in 2019 and using the same curriculum as the Boy Scouts use, the BSA will deliver a new program for older girls, separate from current Boy Scout troops, which will enable girls, young women, to earn the Eagle Scout rank. I have already had the pleasure of meeting several young women who told me they can't wait for that opportunity to occur. And from those conversations, they have already mapped out how many months it will take them when we will recognize the first female Eagle Scout at an event like this. Change, particularly an historic change like this, can be quite hard for organizations like ours. The Boy Scouts of America is one of our nation's iconic programs and has had a powerful influence, on our youth since 1910. I bring this up tonight, not because I plan to lay out all the details involved in these changes. There is an excellent video we posted on our Facebook page just this morning if you're interested in learning all those nuts and bolts things. So why do I bring it up? It's pretty much the norm that we'll hear more from those opposed to change and as opposed to those in favor. I accept that, and Scouters are typically very passionate in their beliefs, particularly if they fear that Scouting's traditions are being imperiled. But there's also messages like this voicemail that we received in our office, and this comes from a father. He says, "I happen to be an Eagle Scout. Although it's been many years since I've been involved in the program, now I'm all grown up and I have kids of my own. I actually have two girls. I don't have any boys. I was quite excited the other day to hear that the Cub Scouts and at some point the Boy Scouts will admit girls. As the father of two girls and no boys, I really thought that Scouting was not going to be part of my life. Once upon a time, I sort of envisioned, you know, that I'd go camping with my kids, so I'm kind of excited. There are many families, including our current Cub Scout parents, who love what we do, including our outdoor programs, and would be delighted to be able to have their daughters participate in our programs at the same time and in the same way as their sons. This is not to imply that all of our programs are superior to others. We are not the only organization which builds character. Many of these families tell us they would appreciate the convenience of having their whole family being able to participate together in the same scouting program, especially when schedules are already crammed with lots of other activities." Excuse me. "I told you earlier about our two sons. We also have a daughter who is the twin of our eldest son. Given what I do for a living, she got to see quite a bit of our scouting programs when she was very young. She saw what her daughters did as Cub Scouts, she saw what her brothers did as Cub Scouts and what they got to do at summer camp at Tuckahoe. She tried Brownies for a year or so, but her group just didn't have the same outdoor opportunities as she saw her brothers having in their Cub Pack. She never publicly let on that it bothered her until there was a Sunday morning. I remember it like it was yesterday. Our sons were getting ready to go to Scout Camp. They were in their uniforms. We were getting ready to drive into Tuckahoe. They were slouching on the couch, and they were complaining that they had to go to summer camp, and they'd rather not. This did not go well with their sister that day, who basically went off on them. I have to paraphrase what she said that morning. But she let her brothers know in the clearest possible terms that she couldn't believe they were complaining about having to go to camp, that they routinely got to do things she never had the chance to do and would have loved to do. And here they were complaining. All of us stopped to hear what she had to say. She was loud, and there was no mistaking what she felt. Not too many years later, I was invited to teach a course at the Philmont Training Center. Alan Boynton was there as council president, Council Commissioner John Riggle was there. I had been to Philmont before. And when I had the chance to go back, I asked all three of my kids if they wanted to go and backpack for 5 days in the backcountry, because that was something that Philmont offered.
All three immediately wanted to go. But I will tell you, my daughter was the most excited. She was nervous about being able to keep up physically with the boys on the trip. She had never before camped in a tent. She had no backpacking experience. That being said, I really wasn't worried, because when she headed out on the trail with her brothers and the others in the crew, I know the folks at Philmont and the job they do. I knew she would be okay, but I hoped she would have a good time and not be physically exhausted and miserable. So the day they came off the trail, and Alan is here, he will nod his head when I say this, we were standing there waiting, and all three of my kids came bounding off the bus. They were so excited that they had done. As expected, my daughter had really struggled with the trail and the altitude at first, and then things fell into place. It was the best thing she had ever done, she said. And when it was time for her to apply to go to college, she applied to Penn State.
What she chose to write in her entrance application was her Philmont experience. It had changed who she was, she said. Clearly, in
the scout, what we do, maybe even take for granted, mattered a great deal to her. As we approach implementation of the changes to come, I don't necessarily see my role that I'm here to tell you how you should feel about these changes. People inside and outside of the BSA will have strong feelings, and some will oppose what we're trying to do. For me, I'm going to choose to be excited about what lies ahead and embrace that challenge. The expression that I saw that morning on my daughter's face gives me all the motivation that I need, that says we need to provide our daughters as well as our sons with a first-rate experience in Scott. We owe it to all the young people that we serve to do our absolute best. Thanks again to everyone for being here tonight. This is always the highlight of our scouting year.
I always enjoy coming here. As we get ready to see our closing video, I'll let you know that when our video is done, we will stand adjourned. All the best to each of you and your families for a great Thanksgiving and happy holiday season. And now our closing video.
I've never been the one to raise my hand. That was not me, and now that's who I am. Because of you, I am standing tall. My heart is all I need.